Greetings, friends. There's something important that you should know when setting your visual cue setting in NBA 2K24. But before we go ahead and take a look at that, let's go and look at what the visual cue setting is, just in case if you don't know. And so we're going to go into options and then go over to controller settings, and then we're going to make our way down to where it says shot timing visual cue. So what this does is it determines the best time to go and release the jump shot button on your jump shot to go and get that green release. And so as you see down there, set your preferred animation cue to release the button during a jump shot. And so basically you have what you have here is release, jump, set point, and push. And so push, for example, or actually let's start with jump. So jump is very early release. So you need to release the jump shot button really early to go and get that green release. And then set point is early, just early. And then push is late. And then release is very late. And this is what I'm actually using. I'm actually using release. So I'm using very, very late. It's just something I'm comfortable with. And so that is what the shot timing visual cue is, and that is how it works. All right, so the thing I wanted to talk about here is the release speed of the jump shot animation that you're using for your My Player. So this is more to just take a mental note and to be aware of the release speed of the jump shot animation that you're using, combined with that of the visual cue setting that you're using. So let's say that you're using the jump visual cue setting, which as we mentioned earlier is very early, the very early release, and you combine that with a slow jump shot, kind of like what I'm using here with Chris Webber, which his release speed is only a D. So it's just important to just kind of keep that in mind if you're mixing and matching like that, and to practice, simply practice and get used to that, because it's two different things. So a very early visual cue combined with a slow and late kind of jump shot. So it's important to kind of keep that in mind, and like I said, work on that if you're mixing and matching. So if you feel like you're struggling that way, then go with a jump shot and a visual cue that kind of match. So if you are using a slower jump shot like this one, then maybe you want to go with the release visual cue instead, so that way it kind of matches together a little bit, if that makes sense. So, or of course, like a lot of people, they create their own jump shot, and you know, whatever you're using, it could be any of the base animations or the jump shot creator jump shot that you make, things like that. So but it's always important to make sure you go and practice. So if you are doing a little mixing and matching between the visual cue and the release speed of your animation, then like I said, make sure to definitely practice and get used to it if you like it that way. But so that's the thing I just wanted to point out. So it's not like the end of the world or whatever, it's not a permanent thing. You can always just kind of, you know, tweak it how you want and things like that. So it's no big deal. Just go and just, like I said, switch things up a little bit, practice stuff like that, and then you'll have that jump shot down. Next thing you know, you'll be hitting threes and mid-range shots like it's going out of style. So that's what I wanted to point out. Alright y'all, make sure to go and watch this next video to know about this new NBA game that features a 3v3 blacktop style gameplay. And I'll talk to you next time. Peace, adios, sayonara. Ghost Panda, out of here.